Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Friends, welcome back to my channel. I have this 24 volt 250 watt 10 ampere power supply. It is not powering on. Let's see what is the problem. If you don't have good practical experience in power electronics, never try to repair because it have unisolated live electrical voltage. Let's check it. The left two pins line and neutral, and the right three pins positive voltage, and these three pins common, and this is ground pin. We will use series lamp to apply power, and we will see this lamp condition. I applied power, but it is not turning on. The LED is off, fan is off. First, I will check AC voltage. It have 233 volt input. I will check DC voltage. No output. Let's open it and we will see what is the problem here. Because the lamp did not turn on, that means its input circuit is not responding. Might be the fuse is open or anything damaged. Let's check it. Its fuse is damaged. That means it has something short circuit. Something is drawing overcurrent, so due to overcurrent condition, the fuse will burn out. Its components are looking good. This class X capacitor is looking good. Class Y capacitors are looking good. Let's see what's wrong here. First, we will monitor DC voltage at DC rail. So it is 0 volt. It is safe. Here it is using SSH8N80 MOSFET, and it is using here 3845 IC. First, we will check continuity or in diode mode between drain to source. Open diode, protection diode. That means this MOSFET is good. It don't have short circuit at DC rail. In the first step, we will check bridge rectifier. This is cut side, so it is positive terminal. At positive terminal, we will place black lead. One diode, second diode. Okay. Now, red lead here. Open, open. Okay. Red lead at negative terminal. One diode, second diode. Diode. So that means bridge rectifier is good. DC rail is safe. MOSFET is safe. And if we check AC input side of the bridge rectifier, it is open circuit. That means there is no short circuit here. So first, for test purpose, I will use this 1 ampere bus fuse wire. And we will check the circuit condition using series lamp. I connected fuse here and now I will apply power and we will see the condition of the series lamp. Yes, it's turned on, but we don't have LED indication here. Let's check output voltage here. No voltage. Let's check drain to source voltage, 326 volt. Let's check voltage across this snubber diode. It don't have any voltage. That means it is not switching. Now we will check supply voltage of this IC. You see 3845, pin 5 is ground, pin 7 is supply pin. There are no voltage. And if we check pin 8, pin number 8 must have 5 volt reference. MOSFET have voltage, but this IC is not receiving power now. So we need to trace the circuit. Now if we check DC rail voltage, 326 volt, check voltage drain to source, the same voltage that are present at drain to source, that means the MOSFET is blocking voltage. It is not switching. When it will switch, there will be a difference between this voltage and this voltage. Now we will check voltage at VCC capacitor here. That is here. No voltage. Wait until these capacitors are discharged. If you want to discharge it urgently, you can use discharging kit to discharge these capacitors. And now check voltage. Now it is safe. Here is VCC capacitor. This one is return line. This is positive. This side, it is connected to this VCC winding through this rectifier diode. This diode is short circuit. It is giving continuity. That means this, if this diode is short circuit, any voltage coming from charging line will go to ground side through this winding. We have one resistor here, that is this one, and in series with this we have another resistor. So two resistors are connected in series from this point, positive side here and here. It is coming to this point. If we check this resistor, yes. So resistors are good. That means this diode is bad. From this positive pin we have two paths. When in initial stage it will receive positive voltage from this point to here through this resistor, then through this resistor it will reach here and this capacitor will start to charge. When this IC will start switching, at that time it will switch primary voltage in this winding and we will receive auxiliary voltage here. If this diode is short circuit, at that time it will not allow to charge this capacitor. I will remove this diode now. Wow, this diode is good. I removed diode from this point and now we will check between these two points. That's really wonderful. We have short circuit at pin number 7, VCC pin. Maybe this capacitor is short circuit or IC is short circuit. Because when I remove this diode is good. That means we have short circuit at this point. So here we have two items. First I will remove this capacitor. Discharge it in capacitors mode. Check capacitors. 106 microfarad. It is 100 microfarad. This capacitor is good. We will check short circuit here. Still we have short circuit. That means this IC is damaged. I will install back this capacitor and now we will replace this IC. We will remove this IC to check the continuity. I will install back this diode. Now I will remove IC to verify the short circuit condition. Yes, now there is no short circuit. Now if we check this IC pin number 5 and 7, so this IC is short circuit internally. So this IC is damaged. I will replace this IC now. I will use this 3845 IC. When you are soldering the IC, never solder in one line, because if you will solder in one line, that time the IC may damage because its substrate temperature may increase and this IC will damage permanently. Verify the gap between pins. Sometimes the solder parts are there. Now let's apply power. Wow, that's awesome. We can see the LED is now powered on. DC voltage 24 volt, yes, that's nice. It have regulated output. Now if we check voltage at pin number 5 and 7, VCC pin 19 volt, reference pin 4.9 volt. This is good working condition of this IC. Before this, due to short circuit of this IC, there were no voltage at pin number 7 and 8, but now we have voltage. Now this IC is working good and this power supply started working. Now I will assemble it. I will remove all the existing heatsink compound and I will apply new heatsink compound on power MOSFET and rectifier, and I will install original value fuse, and this power supply is now started working. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching.